Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Ricardo and I'm Bojo Boosted. I'm very excited because after the success of my 7 weekly spread layouts ideas video, I have decided to finally film a video about 5 daily spread layouts. So as usual, I have created a spread within my Boho Berry community journal right here, and I'm going to show it to you in a moment. Before diving into today's video, if you haven't already, go check out my very first episode of my new series called Boho Berry Your Study Life. The brand new series where I give you 3 tips about a certain subject on every single week, plus I show you my stationery item of the week. So with no further ado, let's get started. Alright guys, so for today's video, I have first created a whole spread about the daily spread. I'm going to explain what a daily spread is, how you should use it, what you should include, and I'm gonna give you tips and tricks on how you can improve your experience with your daily spread. If you're new to bullet journaling, I highly recommend to go through this part of the video because I'm really going back to the basics. I know that lots of you who watch my videos haven't started a bullet journal yet, so I really wanted to go as deep as I could into this subject so that I could give you a clear explanation of how the system works. However, if you're more interested into the 5 daily spread layouts, you can fast forward the video. I'm going to talk about them towards the second part of my video. So first of all, what is a daily spread? So the daily spread is the spread that you use for rapid logging. In your daily spread, you want to write down your tasks, the appointments, and the notes, plus the signifiers as you go. This is the most important part of the bullet journaling system because that's where you use the bullets. I know that for some of you, when you first approach the whole bullet journaling world, the very first thing you see is nice spreads and lettering, hand drawing, and everything is nice. And some people may feel insecure about actually starting a bullet journal. However, rapid logging in your daily spread is something that all of you can do with only just a journal and a pen. That's why this system is powerful. So basically, the daily spread is just a blank page where you write in the date and then all of the different entries. And when doing that, use the bullets and the signifiers in order to rapidly log things in as you go through your day. The very basic daily spread should include these things right here: the date on which you're writing and all the different entries, or bullets as you prefer. So you have 3 different type of entries. You have tasks, appointments, and notes. For tasks, you can either use a dot like this or a box. And whenever you do the task, you cross the dot or the box like this, right? For appointments, you use a circle. And when you attend the appointment, you tick the circle. And for notes, you use a dash like that. Of course, these are not fixed bullets. You can use whatever bullet works for you. I've seen triangles. I've seen all sort of different shapes. Just remember, in your daily spread, you want to be able to log a certain information within the smallest amount of time possible. That's the interest of having bullets. Also, it is very important to have signifiers. You use signifiers next to your entries in order to contextualize your entries. I'm going to focus more on signifiers in a moment. So remember, the most important thing about the daily spread is rapid logging. And rapid logging is supposed to be rapid. It's supposed to be fast. So this system allows you to log a specific information within a few seconds. So what you do is that whenever you have an information that you want to log into your bullet journal, you take your daily spread and you add a bullet and you write that kind of information. Then you can add your signifier in order to contextualize the entry. Also, I wanted to focus on a different point which wasn't that clear to me when I first started bullet journaling. When you do bullet journaling, you log things into your daily spread as you go. That means that you would log in
all kind of information, even information that is not related to the current date you're in. Some people have told me that they do not see the point of having bullet journaling because they need to know the date, they need to know where to log things in. Example, let's say you call the doctor, right? And you need to set an appointment. You want to write in your system when this appointment will be. Let's say the appointment is next week on Tuesday, all right? But you don't have your weekly spread set up already. You don't have the daily spread for that specific date. But still, that's an information that you got today and that you want to log in to your daily spread. So in that case, you can add a note that says appointment with the doctor next week on Tuesday. That information does not relate to the specific day you're writing in, but still you would log in on that day because then what that happened. That's the easiest thing to do. Bullet journaling is supposed to be easy. Remember, bullet journaling is a system that is supposed to help you externalize all sort of information that you want to work on in order to get things done and be productive. That's why when logging things in your daily spread, you shouldn't worry about the date, you shouldn't worry about what kind of information it is. Just think about what kind of entry it is, so a task, an appointment, or a note. You write that information in, and then you leave it there. That's why it's called rapid logging, because you do that throughout your day. You just open your journal, you log that thing in, and then you go back to work. Then later at night, for example, when you're back home, when you do have time, you know, to work on your scheduling, on your planning, you go back to all of your entries and you start working on them. This way you'll find journaling much, much easier and less stressing, because I've seen that some people do find the system stressful when it's really not supposed to be like that. So at night, when you go back to all of the things that you logged in during that day, you can start setting up the daily spread for your following day. And that's when you can set the tasks that you want to do on the following day. If you do your rapid logging during the day without caring about what kind of information it is, what day it is, plus you're planning at night on the previous day, you'll see that you'll be able to be way more productive than you think you could be. It is very important when you go through your tasks that you're sure that all the tasks in your daily spread are completed, canceled, or migrated. I plan on doing a video all about the migration in my bullet journal. Basically, what you do when you do not get a certain task done, you either cancel it if it's not relevant anymore, or you migrate it. That means that you move it forward to your schedule so that you'll get it done on a different date. I have a little trick that I use in my bullet journal in order to know whether I completed, canceled, or migrated all of my tasks, and that's to tick the down corner of the page when all of the tasks have been processed. So this is not my idea, I've seen it on Instagram, but I just can't remember whose idea it is, so I'm sorry about that. I'm gonna show you how I do that in my bullet journal. Let's go back for a moment to one of my older bullet journals. As you can see here I have my dailies with all of my tasks and all of the entries and the signifiers. And in the corner right here, I tick the page if I processed all that kind of information. This way, I'm sure that there is no task that I need to work on this page. And this has been extremely useful and extremely helpful to me. Next, I wanted to focus on this question because some people have asked me how much room a daily spread should take. So the answer is as much as needed. If you have a lot of things to write down, then just keep on writing. If you have a lot of entries, that means that you have a lot of information that you want to log in. So write as many notes, as many tasks, as many appointments as you want. And remember, you can always go back to all that list so that you can process things later on during the day. Or, for example, some days you may feel really lazy or that you have nothing important or useful to write in, so you can just skip the daily. That's absolutely fine. Also, if you want, you can draw your dailies in advance. I've been drawing my dailies in advance mostly because I have some different trackers in my daily setup. Be aware that if you do draw your dailies in advance, you may end up not drawing some days and having a couple of pages blank, and you do not want that. Personally, when that happens, I would draw some doodles in or do some coloring. But remember, the most important thing still is rapid logging. Moving on, I wanted to focus more on signifiers. So the signifiers are the symbols that you write next to your entries in order to contextualize them. So set your own signifiers, be creative, have fun. This is one of the things that I love the most about my system. So here are mine so that I could give you some ideas. Here I have this small little envelope for mailing, texting, and phone calls. I have this one for urgent tasks. This one for a music I like, I would associate this with note. So I would write a note with the title of the song and put this next to it so that I know that it's some music. I use this one for filming for my YouTube channel. I use this one for things that I need to look up. This is extremely useful because sometimes you may want to look things up, but you do not have time. This is for all money-related stuff. For example, if you need to go to the bank. This is all study-related. I'm using this one or the Chinese character if you've seen my other videos. This one is whole home related, that's for cleaning, for something that I need to fix, for something that I need to buy. This one is for things that I love. I use this one for some great idea or inspiration, that's especially for my Bujo Boosted world. I have a really great idea for a spread, for a video. Find your own set of signifiers, work with them, and have fun. Okay, now before diving into the 5 daily spreads, I wanted to give you a live demo of how this whole rapid logging system works. So the very first thing that we want to do is to write in the date. I'm gonna go for the very basic layout, so nothing fancy. Let's say you have something scheduled. Let's say you have an appointment, you have a meeting at 10 a.m. So you write down the bullet for appointments, you write all kind of information, and you can add a signifier right here. So for example, that could be very urgent. Then, when you are with Jake during the meeting, he tells you about this great website that you should really look up. So, in that case, you can add a task right here. And it's something you want to look up. You go back home and you know that you need to clean the floor, for example. So you add one more task, clean the floor. You add the signifier. Then let's say you're watching TV and you listen to a great song. Then a friend of you call you, right, and tells you that there is a party next Friday, let's say. So in that case, you may want to add a note saying, you know, party next Friday. And you need to get a gift for the person, let's say. So it's the end of the day, these are all your entries, and then you go through them. Did you go to the meeting with Jake? Yes, you did. Did you look that great website up? If the answer is yes, then you can cross it. clean the floor. You were too lazy, you know, for doing that. So you are going to move that to your next day. And then you need to still buy a gift for Jake. So you're going to move that to the next day. So see, now here you have all your entries, and you know that all your entries have been processed, so you can take your date here, for example. The point is that it shouldn't take as much time, it should be as fast as possible, as easy as possible. You'll go back to all your entries, and then you'll work on every single entry. Let me know in a comment below if you do have questions about the system rabbit logging and how it works. I'm going to show you my 5 daily spread layouts, and I want to start with mine. So in the daily layout, you can add as many trackers, as many things as you want, and this is my personal setup. There's the date and the tasks and the notes and all that stuff in here. I use a time tracker. And I use some coloring for identifying all the different things that I do throughout the day. I have a water tracker right here, and whenever I drink a certain amount of water, I would color 1 box. And I use these 2 ones to know whether I was active or not on social media. That would mean either post a picture on Instagram, or post a video on YouTube, or reply to all your comments on YouTube or on Instagram, and so on. This is the box that I use for my Chinese word of the day. If you've been following me, you know that I'm studying Chinese and that I'm trying to learn 1 Chinese word per day. And I love to have that box on my daily so that I do remember to do that. Also, I have this small section right here for my gratitude. Being grateful every day is very healthy, and I used to have a whole gratitude log within my monthly setup. I've decided to switch to a more daily gratitude setup because I find that with this format, I don't forget to do my gratitude. Moving on, my second daily spread layout, of course, it's from Boho Berry. I absolutely love her. That's why I first started bullet journaling. And I am so, so grateful that I found her YouTube channel 1 year ago. She has the date up here. She uses a time tracker as well. And she uses this nice little duals for knowing when she wakes up and when she goes to sleep. Then she has a small doodle for the weather. Here she enters the forecast for a day. That could be very important so that you know how to prepare for the day. If you need to bring a raincoat or an umbrella. I have seen this on some of her oldest daily spreads, but I found this idea absolutely amazing. She identifies the top 3 tasks that she must get done on that day by using these numbers right here. If you want to use this system, you may want to leave more space for your signifiers. I realized that way too late when I was already done with drawing this spread. So I really love how simple this is. It sticks really much to the basic bullet journal setup. The next daily spread that I wanted to show you is this Spiraldexish daily spread. So if you watched my 7 weekly spread layouts ideas video, you know that I have designed a Spiraldexish weekly spread where I have 1 Spiraldex per day on 2 pages. The Spiraldex works really well in your daily spread. And especially if you have a very busy day and you do need to focus more on where your time is going. So when you draw your Spiraldex, you have here as a clock, the day, the hour from like 6 in the morning all the way to midnight. You can color the area in according to the different projects and classes and all that stuff that you do have. The Spiraldex is something that you do in advance. You can do it the night before the date, for example. That works really well. And then You can add all sort of tasks next to the Spiraldex on this area and log things in as you go through the day down here. Example here, going back to the 14th of September, this worked so well for me. I had drawn this Spiraldex the night before and I had it all color in according to my color coding system. I had this task right here set up the night before. So this area here is for pre-planning. And then I added things in as the day went on. You may want to actually switch from one format to another according to the different day that you're planning for. For example, this day was really busy, so I had to draw a Spiraldex in because I needed to focus more on the time. But on the other days, as you can see, I didn't have as much going on, so I didn't need a Spiraldex. Moving on, I have this amazing daily spread from Rozmakesplans. I've seen this on Instagram and it's absolutely amazing. So what you do is that you draw this thing here. You have the time from 7 to 11 p.m. This works like a Spiraldex, but it gives you more space and you have a clear view of all your time boxes. If you don't know what time boxing is, basically look at your schedule, you identify where your free time is, and that would be a time box, and you plan in advance what you want to get done during that time box. For example, here you draw a line that goes from 1 p.m. all the way to 3 p.m., and this is your time box A. And next here, you have all the things that you want to get done during your time box A. And you do the same, for example, here. That goes from 6 to 8. That's your time box B. And you do the same. I absolutely love this idea. I haven't actually started using it yet, but I do plan on trying this daily spread out, because I really like the idea of time boxing. Go follow her on Instagram. She is absolutely amazing. For my final daily spread of this video, I have decided to design something different. I have the date right here in the middle, the weather here on this side, and my checkup section on this side. If you don't know about my checkup section, go check out my how to track quality video in my channel. And here I have two areas within the daily spread. I have this area for everything that's pre-planned, let's say the night before, and this area for all the entries. Also, the pre-planned areas is divided into different categories. To me, that would be university and social, so that I know that on that day, this is what it was planned and that's what I really need to get done. These are things that you want to have within this part of the spread before, as soon as you wake up. So you wake up, you look at your daily spread, and you have this part filled in already. Then, as you move in throughout your day, you have all your entries on this side. I really like the fact of being able to actually have a clear separation between what I planned in advance and what I'm logging in throughout the day. And also, I like the fact of having different categories right here.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please tap the like button down below and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for weekly videos. I post videos every Saturday, and from this week on, I'll be posting on Thursday as well. Every Thursday, I'll be posting one episode of my Boho Boost Your Study Life series. Let me know in a comment below what you thought about today's video and what you thought about the spreads that I've showed you. So I hope you all have a great weekend, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!